That was in Puerto Rico. It was no money corner. When I grew up in Puerto Rico, I ran around barefooted. So my family were hippies. So I suffered for a lot of years without knowing it.
What's the best thing about being in boxing?
Well, the best thing of being in boxing is having a great champion. That's everybody's dream. Yeah. As a trainer. Yeah. You only need one. I don't need 10 of them. One. One is good.
Now, you
it takes
said,
a lot of work, man, to have one champion.
You said earlier that Danny's your fighter, not your son.
Right.
Can you talk a little more about that?
Well, the thing what I say about that is I love him to death. Don't get me wrong. I'm his dad at the end of the day. And he's my son. I'm never going to want nothing bad for Dan. But when it's a brutal sport, I know the sport. So basically, you got to be mentally strong. So I got to prepare him for that.
Yeah.
So I can't be soft, because then we have two soft energies, not going to work out.
Yeah.
You got to be spiritually strong, mentally strong in this game. If you know you're going into a ring, brother, who wants to fight? You want to fight me right now. And I say, let's go outside. You're going, whoa. You're going to be like, yo, come on, man. Stop this guy. Nobody likes fighting. That's the worst thing anybody want to do. Fight. Everybody want to fight, just tell them, come on, let's go outside.
Yeah, that's true.
And then everything changed. You'll be like, oh shit.
He's real.
Man, somebody told me a story once that you took Danny to an amateur tournament.
Oh, yeah.
And he lost the fight.
Well, no. When he was younger, he used to lose to himself. I knew that the hump, it was to get him over that hump.
Yeah.
It takes a lot of work to jump somebody's hump, meaning his mind.
Yeah.
So my job, and I knew the problem he had was he would lose to himself before he got in the ring. So when we used to go to the ringside, it cost me a lot of money. Remember, nobody sponsors boxing.
Right.
It cost me a lot of money as a kid for traveling.
Right.
We get there, he lose the first night. Not only one time, he did that a couple times.
Yeah.
The last time I was looking, he's running around eating hot dog, all happy. I'm like, oh, young boy, you got it tonight. When we went to the room, I gripped him, threw him against the wall. I didn't abuse him. I just whooped his ass up.
Yeah.
I'm a little shook. And I gave him a, if you ever lose again, I'm going to kick your brains all over and threw him into the bait.
Yeah.
Never look back after that.
Right.
Never lost again?
Never lost after that. Won the U.S. Under 19 USA Championship, 2006, 2007, 2008. Olympian, alternate.
And
he should have been the Olympian, bro.
I know, I saw that fight. It was
2008,
yeah. 2008, I saw that.
But that's okay. Because that's how God wanted.
How
I used to tell Danny, don't worry, Dan. God got better things in store for you. He might not win this, but look who he is today. Champion.
The other guy,
he's nobody.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Because that was meant to be. This was meant to be. That was chosen. They sent us out with the judge. You know, in the amateur, they do that shit.
And could he have been the fighter yesterday without you? Could he have been the fighter he is right now?
I don't think so, no. No. Because he had other training when he was a kid. I let him work with some other guys. And I used to be in the corner with him.
Mm-hmm.
And then when the other guy, I used to argue with the guy while Danny be fighting me and the guy be arguing in the corner.
Where?
For real, bro. It's a true story.
I believe
it. Ask him.
I believe
it. He be arguing. Because I didn't want Danny to fight like that. I was like, oh, this ain't the man. I'm going to take it to the next level. And I told him, I'm going to take it to the next level. If it's not me, it's nobody. You choose either them or me. And I gave him an option. He chose me. Thank God.
Where would
I would have chose you too.
Huh?
I would have chose you
no,
too.
No, you're right. Thank you. My brother-in-law told me that shit now.
Yeah.
When he came out of Pantene, he was 130. I used to tell him, let me train. I was young at the time. I used to tell him, let me train. No, no. So we used to go to Champ's Gym and spar in Philly.
Yeah.
And he'd be sparring and shit. I'd be like, dude, let me train you, bro. This boy is like, he don't know what. He used to look at me like I was too young. You know what he tells me now? Damn, I should have listened to you. I said, you're talking 20 years later, buddy. Too late.
Too late. Way too late.